Hi everyone, my name is Ian Cohn and I am a graduate student in the labs of Chris Hunter and Boris Treatman at the University of Pennsylvania. Today I will tell you about our paper entitled Intestinal CDC1s Provide Cues Required for CD4 T-cell Mediated Resistance to Cryptosporidium. Cryptosporidium is a unicellular protozoan apicomplexan parasite. The parasite infects cells of the epithelial lineage and undergoes multiple rounds of asexual and sexual replication within an intracellular but extracytoplasmic niche in the epithelium of a single host. In the 1980s during the AIDS pandemic, Cryptosporidium rose to prominence as individuals with severely depressed CD4 T-cell counts presented with Cryptosporidium disease, leading to morbidity and mortality. Since that time, Cryptosporidium has become appreciated as a cause of severe diarrhea and death in individuals with impaired CD4 T-cell function, as in the setting of AIDS, but also in immunosuppression during organ transplantation and in primary immunodeficiencies. Despite its appreciation as a human pathogen since the 1980s, the mechanisms whereby CD4 T-cells protect against Cryptosporidium infection and establish immune memory have remained poorly understood. This is due to the paucity of tools for understanding antigen-specific responses to the parasite. With the recent development of tools for genetically manipulating Cryptosporidium parasites, we used CRISPR-Cas9 to create strains of Cryptosporidium for tracking CD4 T-cell responses. We engineered parasites to express small model antigens as peptide tags on the C-terminus of the parasite effector protein metal 2, which is exported into the host cell epithelium during infection. We generated two strains, one that expresses the 2W1S model antigen, which is the target of endogenous T cells in B6 mice, and the LCMV GP61 to 80, or GP61 antigen, which is the target of TCR transgenic T cells from SMARTA mice. As you can see here, when host cells get infected with these transgenic strains in vitro, Cryptosporidium, shown in green, exports metal 2 model antigen fusion protein, shown in red, into the cytoplasm of infected host cells. When mice receive CD45.1 positive SMARTA T cells, in the absence of infection, we are unable to find CD45.1 positive cells in the intestines of mice. However, when mice are infected with GP61 expressing Cryptosporidium, we can see robust expansion of these T cells in the intestines of infected mice. This suggests that this new strain can be used to track antigen-specific T cells against the parasite. Using our new strains of Cryptosporidium, we discovered that type 1 conventional dendritic cells, or CDC1s, are dispensable for priming of CD4 T cells during infection, but are required for driving expression of gut homing molecules in the mesenteric lymph node. Therefore, in the absence of CDC1s, CD4 T cells fail to home to the gut. Additionally, we found that CDC1s are required for producing IL-12 in the gut to drive local interferon gamma expression by CD4 T cells that control the parasite. Importantly, these studies and tools can be used to develop vaccines against Cryptosporidium, which is not only a cause of disease in immunocompromised individuals, as I mentioned in the beginning, but is also a major cause of diarrhea, death, and growth stunting in malnourished children globally.